Hello again, I'm Rodney Reynolds from 3dgameman.com, and this Q&A video is about what you should be looking for when you are purchasing a case. First of all, you want to know what kind of hardware that you'll have and the purpose for the case. In other words, you know, if you're going for a hardcore setup with, you know, a couple of video cards and water cooling and all that kind of stuff, you might need a larger case, something that has more function and style. If, for example, you're doing a lot of LAN parties, maybe you want to get a case that has a handle. If you're in an office, it's a completely different setup altogether. So consider that first. Next is your budget. Only get a case that you can't afford. There's no sense in spending extra money on a case when you can pour that money somewhere else. Like, for example, if you're into gaming, pour that money into a better video card or another video card. So keep your budget at the top of the list. It's very important to get a case that is both stylish, something that you like to look at, and also one that is functional. Don't go with a case that is all about the looks, and don't go with a case that is all about the feature list. Get something that you're going to be able to admire for a very long time, because if you do it right, a case should last you for a very, very long time. Case material might or might not be important to you. Some people prefer all aluminum cases because, first of all, they look fantastic. They are more expensive though, but they are lightweight in comparison to steel cases, which are mainly comprised of steel, plastic mesh, and sometimes accents like aluminum. Drive bays are very important, and get a case that has enough for your particular use. Also consider a case that has a toolless drive bay design, because that will make installing and removing drives a snap. Having lots of fans and removable dust filters to go along with those fans is very important. You want to keep the inside of the case cool at all times, but you also want to keep the dust out. Connectors, buttons, and LEDs are very important, and the position of them also can be important. Like, for example, if you have your case on the floor, then it's great to have all of these ports and buttons at the top for easy access. However, if your case is on your desk, you might want to have them on the front of the case instead. And also get a case that has enough ports for your particular application. Some people prefer a reset button that's hidden, maybe a power button that's hidden, and that type of thing. So check it out and see what works best for you. Side panels are sometimes overlooked, but they do play a crucial role. For example, in this particular situation, each side panel has acoustic foam on the inside. So this case is designed to be quiet, and each side panel is plain. There's nothing on it. But other cases will have a window or windows, fan or fans, as well as lots of ventilation. So I'll leave that up to you. You decide on what you want for your particular use. I would recommend, if you're going for, you know, a gaming case, get a case that comes with a side panel that has a window as well as at least a fan on it, so you can pull some cool air on top of the hot components that are inside of the case. Lots of things to look for at the back of the case. You want to make sure that the install location for the power supply is at the bottom. You want a fan exhausting warm air at the back top. Make sure that there's at least 7 expansion slots. Some cases have more. Also, you can get them that are ventilated, and as well make sure that they come with a toolless design, because it will make installing and removing cards that much easier. Some cases have a lock, so you can secure the left side panel. That might or might not be important to you depending upon where your case is. Also, cases generally come with thumb screws these days, at least the side panel that accesses all of the hardware inside of the case. Sometimes cases have proprietary designs for removing and installing the side panels. Also, if you're into water cooling, get a case that has at least 2 holes in the back for routing, you know, water cooling tubes and cables through. In most situations, you'll want to get a case that is spacious. Make sure that you have enough room to work, and most importantly, make sure that you have enough room inside of the case to install everything that you need to, like for example, a video card or video cards, a cooler, power supply, motherboard, and other items. Maybe you're into water cooling and that type of thing. Also consider a case that comes with a removable motherboard tray, because it will make installing and removing components away from your computer system that much easier. The beauty about a removable motherboard tray is you can take that tray to your workbench away from your case where there's lots of space to do what you need to do, and then bring it back. Also, make sure that there's a hole on the motherboard tray for easy access to the cooler's retention plate, because that will be an enormous time saver. Also, cable management is very important. You want to organize the cables and also make sure that there is enough space behind the motherboard tray and the right side panel to route cables and keep them out of the inside of the case. That's for look, but also for airflow inside the case. On some cases, the front and top panels are very easily removed, and that might be important to you. Also get a case that has soft feet, because it will cut down on the vibrations as well. It will prevent the surface that you're putting the case on from being scratched. Remember, if you have a question for me, head on over to 3dgamingman.com and post it in the forum. I'll provide a link below to the Q&A video on 3dgamingman.com so you can leave a comment or post a question. And remember, you can post there anonymously.